Welcome back. Today's career video is for a player who only played for two teams. So, kept it simple, went with the big logos for both. He had quite the run with both franchises. And that's Scott Niedermayer. Scott Niedermayer, who I thought I had to have done his Niedermayer video, and then I did a quick search, and I haven't. So, number three pick in 1991. The fact that he's drafted in 1991 by the Devils is newsworthy because this was a draft pick they had acquired from the Toronto Maple Leafs in exchange for Tom Curvers. And it's a trade that I think Toronto ended up regretting. I don't think I'm going that far out on a limb to say it. And he's drafted in 91 as the number three pick, and there was a lot of hype about him coming into the NHL. And for the New Jersey Devils, a team which, you know, Stevens, Niedermayer, it's a ridiculous blue line. So 91-92, he only plays four games, has one assist, but that's your getting your foot in the water. And then he really dives in the following year, 92-93. He ends up on the all-rookie team, 80 games played, 11 goals, 29 assists, 40 points. In five playoff games, he records three assists. 93-94. This was the year where the New Jersey Devils took that step. The New Jersey Devils had been called a Mickey Mouse franchise in the 80s by Gretzky. And they really had been. And they had a run in 88 with Sean Burke. But there really hadn't been any since sustained success with New Jersey. But it starts in 94. His numbers in 94, 81 games, 10 goals, 36 assists, 46 points. And in the playoffs, 20 games, 2 goals, 2 assists, 4 points. 20 games as they went to the conference final, where they would lose against the New York Rangers, who would win the Stanley Cup. And New Jersey took that personally. As 94-95, Scott Niedermayer shows what everybody would find out. You want to win? Get Scott Niedermayer. 48 games played in the lockout shortened season. 4 goals, 15 assists, 19 points. So not tremendous numbers, but Niedermayer wasn't just about the offense. With Niedermayer, it was really the all-around game. He was such a good defenseman. And as the years went along, he got more and more noticed for how good he was. They win the Stanley Cup, 20 games played in the playoffs, 4 goals, 7 assists, 11 points. So his goal total in the playoffs equals his goal total during the regular season. And there you go. 95-96, bit of a setback year for New Jersey. Not as much for Niedermayer. In 79 games, 8 goals, 25 assists, 33 points. So he's able to stay healthy. He is, again, remarkably consistent, excellent at both ends of the ice. And there's a lot of leadership there with Scott Niedermayer, too. So whatever you need from him, you get it. So 96-97, 81 games played, 5 goals, 30 assists, 35 points. In the playoffs, 10 games played, 2 goals, 4 assists. One thing with Scott Niedermayer's numbers, too, if you look at the offense numbers, you say, well, that's not that impressive. This is when the New Jersey Devils are playing the trap. New Jersey was not a team that had a lot of scoring going on. It wasn't a wide open game. And the conversation around Niedermayer was, man, if he played for a team that was really good offensively, he'd be scoring 60 points a year. And that was a conversation that was, you know, seemed to have a lot of validity to it. And we would find out after he got to Anaheim that was the case. 97-98, 81 games, 14 goals, 43 assists, 57 points. So this is the highest point total he would get in New Jersey. In the playoffs, 6 games played and 2 assists. He ends up a second team All-Star. He goes to the All-Star game because defensemen get recognized more when they're scoring more points and more goals, right? It's the same thing with the defensive forward. It's one of the weirdest things to me about the Selke Trophy is that you'll see a player win a Selke Trophy. He's been an excellent defensive forward his whole career. But that year that he has really good offensive numbers, suddenly he's in the Selke conversation, and I still find that weird. So 98-99, 72 games, 11 goals, 35 assists, 46 points. He's not in the All-Star game. He's not on one of the All-Star teams at the end of the year. 7 games, 1 goal, 3 assists, 4 points in the playoffs. 99-2000, and this is where it had already been basically said that, well, you know, New Jersey had their run in 95. But 71 games played, 7 goals, 31 assists, 38 points. And again, it's never about the points with Niedermayer. 22 games in the playoffs, 5 goals, 2 assists, 7 points. And a second Stanley Cup ring for Scott Niedermayer. He knows how to win championships. 2000-2001, he only plays 57 games that year. 6 goals, 29 assists, 35 points. So his points total is almost the same as the year before, even though he plays 14 less games. In the playoffs, 21 games and six helpers. No goals in that run. They went all the way to the Stanley Cup Final and lost against the Colorado Avalanche. He did appear in the All-Star game that year. So this is, again, this is where he's starting to get more and more recognition, right? 2001, 2002, 76 games, 11 goals, 22 assists, 33 points. And I don't, I mean, New Jersey was getting better offensively as this is going along. It was less of a trap-style hockey, but you could still see that Niedermayer would probably score more elsewhere. Six games in the playoffs that year for two assists. 2002, 2003, 81 games, 11 goals, 28 assists, 39 points. And in the playoffs, 24 games, 2 goals, 16 assists for 18 points. So in this Stanley Cup run, he scored way more than he did the previous two Cup runs. In fact, he scored the same amount combined. 11 points here, 7 points here, 18 the final time through with 24 games. That's the third and final Cup for the New Jersey Devils, but not the final Cup for Scott Niedermayer. 2003-2004, 81 games played, puts up tremendous totals. In a contract year, 14 goals, 40 assists, 54 points. In the playoffs, he records one goal in five games. He is a first-team All-Star. He wins the Norris Trophy, and he's in the All-Star game that year. So there it is, 54 points. He's a Norris Trophy winner. And yet, again, he was one of the most perfect defensemen. I put it this way, for people who may not have seen him play. I talk a lot about how Patrice Bergeron really doesn't make mistakes. Niedermayer was like that on the blue line. Really didn't make mistakes. There really wasn't a complaint you could have. So even if you look at his points totals and say, well, that wasn't spectacular that year, that's fine. He wasn't making the mistakes in his own end that some defensemen who put up 50-plus points will make. August 4th of 2005, he did the unthinkable. He left New Jersey. He signs as an unrestricted free agent with the Anaheim Ducks. The Ducks are going to get Pronger as well a year later. His first year in Anaheim, it shows what we all kind of knew, which was this guy can score. 82 games, 13 goals, 50 assists, 63 points. 63 points being a new career high, eclipsing the 57 he had in 97-98. In the playoffs, 16 games, 2 goals, 9 assists for 11 points. Producing, first team All-Star, and he was second in Norris voting that year. 2006-2007, 79 games played, 15 goals, 54 assists, 69 points. Yeah. And again, you look at these totals he puts up in Anaheim, and you just ask yourself, so if he hadn't played in New Jersey, right? But if he hadn't played in New Jersey, he wouldn't have the three Cup rings. I guarantee you, Scott Niedermayer was fine with maybe scoring less points and getting more championships. But in the playoffs, a Stanley Cup was on the way, 21 games, 3 goals, 8 assists, 11 points. That is the fourth Stanley Cup championship for Niedermayer. And with Niedermayer and Pronger, that Anaheim defense was just insane. First team All-Star, second in the Norris Trophy voting, and he wins a Conn Smythe Trophy that year. Conn Smythe Trophy absolutely makes up for not winning the Norris. And of course, as I said, his fourth Stanley Cup. 2007-2008, he only plays 48 games, 8 goals, 17 assists, 25 points. And it was interesting because there was some debate. I remember with Niedermayer and with Solani after that Cup, like, so are they done then? Is that the end of it then? In the playoffs, 6 games played, 2 assists. He was in the All-Star game in 2008. 2008-2009, 82 games, 14 goals, 45 assists, 59 points. In the playoffs, 13 games, 3 goals, 7 assists, 10 points. In his final year, he's still producing. 80 games played in 2009-2010, 10 goals, 38 assists for 48 points. He would retire shortly after the season was done on June 22nd of 2010. But if he'd wanted to play, I think he could have played at least another 4 or 5 years. And I think because he was so good defensively, think like Zdeno Chara along the lines of when that offense is gone. If you're still good defensively, if you still provide something tangible that helps your team out, they're still going to find a spot for you on the roster. So in his career, Niedermayer plays 1,263 games, 172 goals to go with 568 assists, 740 points. In 202 playoff games, 25 goals, 73 assists for 98 points. Absolutely fantastic numbers. He's added to the Hall of Fame in 2013, his first opportunity. 2004, he won a gold medal at the World Championships. 1991, he won a gold medal at the World Juniors for Team Canada. And 2004, he gets a World Cup of Hockey gold medal. 2002 and 2010, he wins Olympic gold. And in 1992, he also won the Memorial Cup. If you want to win, go get Scott Niedermayer. Triple gold club, quadruple gold, however you want to look at it. Whatever championship you can win in hockey, he kind of decided to win them all. And it is quite the resume he built up, and there's no wonder why he was in the Hall of Fame immediately when he was eligible. He was just that good. So Scott Niedermayer, one of the best defensemen I've ever seen play the game. And again, it's for he could score, he could do everything, and at his own end of the ice, he was fantastic. So, yeah, Scott Niedermayer, Hall of Famer, and quite the career he built up. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, as always. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe if you're browsing your way through. You just happened upon this video. Thank you guys so much for watching, for all your support. I will talk to you again soon.